What's up, y'all? It's let me clear my throat. It's Friday. I'm doing much better. That's just nothing but phlegm coming up out of my whatever the mucus does to protect your body from whatever. I'm feeling better, y'all. I'm on the mend. I'm getting there. I still am doing everything I was doing before I was under the weather. I'm such a like black person. We never claim illness. But no, I'm feeling better. Went to the gym today. Shouldn't have, but did. Went to the grocery store today, Walmart of all places, Germ Central. But I have my Clorox on deck. I got some Sambucol. My mom said get Sambucol for all you people out there. So I've had everything. I've had here we go. I've had every medicine known to man. So here we are. Yeah, but it's Friday, so I'm happy about that. I didn't have any lurkers on my video camera system today, so I guess that's a plus. Yeah, my husband has a 4-day weekend. Shout out to him. Yeah, he needed it, I guess. We gonna see what kind of chores I can get out of him this weekend. And yeah, life is life, and y'all, but we're still blessed. We on the right side, right? What they say, if you don't have no haters, you ain't popping. Haters is your motivators. You know, they say all those things, but I don't like having haters, but you know, that's life. But other than that, y'all, nothing really exciting came on today. Me and my husband watched a Hulu movie called No Exit. So if you're really bored, you can watch that. That was decent. I don't know what happened at the end because I had to go to work, but seems like something decent happened. I don't know. I was watching it. What else happened? I'm back watching Survivor. This is season 45 and Survivor still has me invested. I still know those people were using sunscreen and taking showers because it is impossible for a redhead to be on a beach and not get sunburned. It's impossible. So Survivor needs to come clean with what they really giving them people out there. What else is going on? Let's look at the news. I kind of glanced at it earlier. I literally always look at the news before I come on here, but then everything goes right out my brain. Sam Bankman freed. He's found guilty in the FTX fraud case. I'm pretty sure he's gonna rat on somebody though, right? There's no way that he couldn't do that. Let me see something, y'all, because when I'm playing Who Run It in the background, anytime I'm playing music with words, it distracts me. And then I can't talk. And I can't have it. I could play some ASMR. Let's see what we got here. Let's see one way I'm here. I could play my normal background music, but I'm gonna be different today and see what the heck this is. Hopefully this isn't too sad. I hate sad music. Of course, it ain't gonna play in the background. You know what? Just forget it. I don't care. I don't care now. Now you've made me mad. But anyway, Sam Bankman-Fried, the FTX dude, yeah, he is going to jail. I'm wondering if he's gonna tell on somebody. There was a game today, Pittsburgh and the Titans, and Pittsburgh won 20-16, and my running back got 14 points. Okay, running back. Okay, I'll take that. Thank you. We'll see if I can win again this week. Last week, I got so lucky. Winning off of a kicker, but we'll see if I can do it again. All right, let's see what else we got going on. Israel says it encircles Gaza City. U.S. to urge for localized humanitarian pauses. Actually, I saw on Fox News today where, you know, Fox News hates all things Democrat, so they put that the title was Biden Practicing Islamophobia, which I thought was pretty funny. Mike Johnson, House Republicans passed Israel aid bill, setting up a clash with Schumer and McConnell and Biden. We'll see. I know Biden said he was going to veto that. Mayor Adams reacts to an FBI raid at his home, at the home of a chief fundraiser. Interesting. What they got on you? And Mayor Adams is a New York mayor, but he's already getting fundraiser raids. That's kind of crazy. Let's see what else they got going on. Former Memphis police officer accused in the death of Tyree Nichols pleads guilty, and he looks like he's gonna cooperate. And if the story that they're telling is true, as far as them beating him up over somebody's ex-girlfriend, I'm snitching on you too. Because I'm not about to go to jail because you and your whatever falling out. Tupac Shakur murder suspect pleads not guilty after court delays. I'm just waiting on him to name Diddy. That's all I'm waiting on. 15 injured, some critically, after a gas explosion and a building collapse in New York. HBO CEO admits he used fake Twitter accounts, including one of a vegan Texas mom named Kelly, to troll critics who left negative reviews of HBO series. That guy is like, you know, I would probably do something like that too. I ain't even gonna lie. But he's so rich. Well, maybe he's not. I don't know. I mean, I would think if he's the CEO of HBO, even though they got bought out by Max, but was he desperate in the final days to troll people from fake accounts? Nurse charged with killing patients with insulin now facing 19 additional charges. Wow. I'm telling y'all, hospitals is sometimes more dangerous than home. Hunter Biden accuses Republicans of weaponizing his drug addiction in the rare op-ed. Just reading through the rest of the stuff, y'all. Tesla workers say they never work in a unionized factory, even as Ford and GM workers are set to get a major pay boost. Interesting. I never met people that wouldn't want to be union. Even though union these days is kind of soft still in my opinion, but you know. Steven Tyler is sued for sexual assault by a former teen model. They've been trying to take Steven Tyler down for a while. Are they getting closer? Will it be R. Kelly first? The world will never know. I'm gonna stay on this R. Kelly thing till something comes out, shakes out, man. Lack of sleep is compromising the mental health of 78% of adults. You don't say. Maybe we should go to 3-day work weeks. I bet you we could get more sleep. But in this age of social media and all this crap, we would still not get sleep because we're psychos. All right, let's see what else we got here. Megan Thee Stallion drops her new single, Cobra. Y'all want to hear it? I don't really want to hear it, but I'll play it. I got problems, never thought like me would ever hit rock bottom. Man, I miss my parents, way too anxious, always cancel my plans. Pull it up, call him cheap, get his fix up, in the same spot I'm sleeping. Lord, give me a break, I don't know how much I am. I got problems, never thought like me would ever hit rock bottom. How long you been worried about me?
about me. Honestly, it kind of feel like you plotting, watching. Why is you speaking on me at my lowest when you acted like you ain't no host tripping? I'm crazy, and they low key hate, so they ain't gonna say. Damn, I finally see, I'm killing myself. Gotta be me. How long you been worried about me?
I hope she wasn't talking about Party, her boyfriend, that he was cheating in her the same bed he was sleeping in. That is not cool. Maybe it gets deeper. Let's see what else we got. Al Pacino has to pay $30,000 a month in child support. Al, you know, you had a baby at, he's like 80 something years old. So, oh well. Don't feel sorry for him at all. Toyota is recalling over 1.8 million vehicles over a potential fire risk. I've talked about this Kardashian stuff, but I'm not playing it because the thought of hearing their voices is annoying. But basically, North says she prefers staying at her dad's house because he doesn't have nannies, and Kim doesn't like that. Whatever. Michigan woman chooses between lottery prizes of $25,000 and a year for life of $390,000 in a one-time payout. She decided to purchase tickets for a recent Powerball drawing while making the online purchases. She also bought the 5 Lucky for Life tickets for October 9th drawing. This was the first time she played. The ticket was the very first Lucky for Life ticket I ever bought when I was purchasing it. Blah, blah, blah. So she took $25,000 for a year, which takes almost 16 years to reach $390,000. So she chose that. $25,000 for life or the one-time payout. Maybe she got a good job. A lot of people thought she should take the one-time payout, but maybe she got a good job and maybe it can go down. Maybe it can get inherited over. Never know what people's thoughts are. Let's see. Two Texas men arrested for stealing 46 packs of oxtail and other meat from multiple grocery stores. I mean, who's buying oxtail? I know oxtail is expensive, though. A Florida driver is cited for a booty patrol truck resembling Border Patrol. I think that's a great idea. Booty patrol instead of Border Patrol. It's okay. Okay. Other than that, let's get into these Reddits, guys. Feel like I can read a little bit better to y'all today. Married men, what changes, if any, have you noticed in your personality after getting married? Not much, just a piece of paper. My family changed a lot, though. Before her accomplishments, warning, congratulations, But after getting married, my dad celebrates her like it was one of his own kids. I used to argue more if you said something wrong in my earshot. That is provable with Google. I would tell you now, I just don't say anything. Someone with anxious attachment, I know she isn't going to walk out the door after the smallest mundane disagreement. That brings me a lot of peace. Nothing changed after getting married first until we bought a house and the kids were born. Married, nothing changed. Kids have a much lower tolerance for BS from adults. Somebody said tired all the time. Somebody said I stopped caring about other women, checking them out. That is perfect. I think every woman wants her husband to answer that question. That is the best answer. That no other woman exists now but your wife. Men, what is some dating love advice that you give women? The obvious ones, be clear, direct. Hints are for treasure hunts. Games are for children. Genuine comments carry huge amounts of weight. For the love of Almighty above, pick where to eat once in a while. I think women should just pick where they want to eat, and then men wouldn't mess up when they suggest something. My biggest piece of advice for both men and women is just stop dating bums. MFers will jump into the worst, most terrible, toxic, useless relationship with someone just because they're hot and or sex is good. The person effing sucks, but I can change them. If I just stick around long enough and show them how much I care, they'll come around. Shut up. Stop. Just don't even get started. I feel somewhat qualified to say this because I've done it, and I'm here to say don't do it. Anything else I would think to add to this conversation has been stated already, but other comments, so that's nice. Yeah, but some people hide their bumness, so it takes some time sometimes. Some people are good at hiding that they're a bum. My biggest tip is to not be afraid of asking guys on dates, being the first to break the touch barrier. Guys don't want to make someone uncomfortable or be called a creep, so a lot of us tend to not ask or risk anything. My husband was acting shy at first. Now, I call him Octopus Hands. But when we were first dating, he was acting all gentlemanly. Huh. I don't know where that guy went. For your drugs, smoking, and alcohol, what is something bad for your health that people don't talk about? Social media. Social media, work. Somebody said a loud environment. My husband works in a loud environment. Is he deaf almost? Absolutely. Not getting enough sleep. Backflips are dangerous. Yeah, I've never done one of those. Sitting down all day, yeah, that's not good for you, especially when you get old, y'all. Somebody says stress. No, stress isn't good for you, but I mean, shoot, man, can you really get rid of it? Every day can be a vacation. I would love, like, in the perfect world, when you're off work and you just be off, and you can spend money and, you know, you don't have no responsibilities, but then you start remembering that you got to keep the lights on and bills got to be paid, so you got to go back to work. But it's nice to try to pretend like maybe you don't have to go back to work for a little bit. What is quickly becoming obsolete? I say people thinking for themselves. Now that we have the internet, people don't want to think for themselves. Electronics repair. Ownership. Everything is subscription. As a bank teller, my job, if there weren't people who still want to bank, like in 1904, my job went, listen, you'll be in business because my husband is still the guy that goes into the bank for everything. Like, if we go out of town, you know how you can just put that you're going out of town online. My husband literally has to go into the bank to tell them. I'm like, dude, it's 2023. Like, come on. Somebody said the fax machine. The fax machine. I hate the fax machine. Photo centers. Slips. Yeah, nobody's wearing a slip anymore. Yeah, a lot of things. But you know what we don't have yet? We don't have the Jetsons level of things where we have something getting us dressed, brushing our teeth, giving us a shower. Like, when are we gonna get that option? Because that's where I'm trying to be at. I might still be like, no, I'm old school, I'm gonna brush my own teeth. But I want the option to say that I'm tired of doing everything by myself. Can you imagine if we had the Jetson level of stuff? I bet you people wouldn't get so much dementia because you wouldn't have to be thinking, what did I forget? You'd have something always remembering stuff for you. What's your favorite thing about your partner relationship? It's a lot, but I would say I just like being around my husband. He makes me comfortable. He's my ace and coon. How sure of himself he is and how easily he calms me down when I get overwhelmed and how natural he prioritizes me and our marriage. I've never doubted for a second that I am number one in his life. He is legit the most intelligent person I've ever met. He has a, I don't even know what that word is, but I don't feel like saying it. My husband's smart too. I always think my husband can do everything, like, even though he says he can't, but if he puts his mind to it, I'll be like, you can do it. Like, you can do it, babe. You could totally build a rocket if you wanted to, freaking take us to the moon. But does he want to? That's key. He's gotta want to do it. But yes, I'm under of that understanding that I think my husband can do everything. Heaps. When people use words like this, I'm like, these words really exist. Heaps. I like that we share the same sense of humor. I poke fun at him and he always shoots back. People are really using the word heaps. Fun. What a fun word. Heaps. Do any ladies prefer guys in briefs over boxers and trunks? I do not like briefs. I hate them. Somebody said depends on the guy. Some rock them, some not so much. My current partner, I buy them for him as well. Well, you might as well buy him a freaking pull-up because that's what they look like. Why do some women consider crying an ick? I've never seen my husband cry. I've known him a decade. He swears he has, but I've never seen it. I think because women, we expect men to be strong. And listen, I know that men are human and they have weak moments. But if we expect the man to be strong and he cries, it's kind of like, if he's crying, then what am I going to do? You know, it's kind of like you look for that your man to be your rock, your strong partner. And so if they break it down, it's like, oh, shoot. If he breaking down, what am I gonna do? Or, you know, if a man, I mean, I've known men that can cry on cue too, and I don't believe none of them tears. So I've seen men cry on cue. Somebody said, I don't know why people cry, it's part of being human. Someone said, anyone who has emotional intelligence of a teaspoon isn't worth interacting with, either men or women, doesn't matter. It's like, why do some men catcall? Because they're whatever. I think anyone who considers crying an ick has some serious issues and emotions. Somebody said, I don't like it when it's used as a manipulation tactic. And that's true. A lot of men, especially if they mess up, cheat, or beat you, they'll start crying. Some woman said, I'm okay with crying. I'm not okay with victimhood. I'm also not okay with crying over spilled milk or crying to be manipulative. something is genuinely upsetting, I will do my best to comfort a person if they cry every day or over something like me. Yeah, like I said, and you'd be surprised, a lot of men do cry on cue. It's kind of unsettling. Anybody that cries on cue is unsettling, though, male or female. All right, let's get into these story times.
Very disturbing case out of Connecticut. A home health nurse was found dead in the basement of one of her patients. And it goes from bad to worse. So Joyce Grayson, the nurse, her name was just released, had apparently retired as a nurse and then went back to work because, you know, nurses can never get out of nursing. She and her husband had fostered like 35 kids over the years, one foster parent of the year in 2017. You know, an amazing person by all accounts. She had an 8 a.m. appointment on Saturday to go see her patient. And when no one heard from her and she missed her following appointments, they tracked her GPS on her phone and it was still at that patient's house, a halfway house. Police went there. They couldn't find him. They left. Later that afternoon, the patient's ankle bracelet showed that it had been tampered with, and they went back and found him. He had some drug paraphernalia on him. Eventually, canine unit led them, followed the scent from her car, which was nearby, to the house, and they found her in the basement, and law enforcement is calling it one of the worst cases they have seen in their 27-year career. They have not released manner of death yet, but by all accounts, it was pretty gruesome. So this patient, 38-year-old, is a known sex offender with violent tendencies. Yeah. So why did the home health agency, who was aware of his history and his violent tendencies, why did they accept this referral? Because you don't have to accept every referral. You don't. But they did. And now a nurse is dead because of it. Yeah. This person had been arrested 3 times. He was in prison from 2007 to 2020. Multiple accounts of sexual assault. He was living in this halfway house. They found her key fob for her car and her credit cards on him, on his person. He still has not been charged with her murder. He is a suspect, but not charged. He's only charged at this point with possession of drug paraphernalia, larceny, and violating probation. He's being held on $1 million bond. His next court date is November 8th. Why? I mean, I know why. We know the answer is money, right? God forbid you turn down a referral that equates to money when you could just put a nurse in harm's way and have worst case scenario happen, right? Why are we accepting referrals? And I've worked in home health, okay, for a long time. Like, I know how this works. Why are we accepting referrals from violent felons? Come on.
That is crazy. And as innocent as home health seems, you know, you think you're just going to be there taking care of somebody that needs you. Shoot, man, if you really think about it, who could show up? Crazy family member, anything. So it's kind of a dangerous job if you really think about it.
No time for an introduction. Let's go ahead and get into it. Today we're going to be talking about some killer strippers. Let me introduce to you Latisha, Jonisha, Ponisha. I'm not making these names up. And the Beyonce of the group, Brittany.
It's Brittany, bitch.
Man, them Newports and Fordies is tearing her ass up. I mean, to be 28 years old and look like this, she does not look a day younger than 43. You know, Brittany told them hoes do some stretches and get in formation. Now, I read through the grapevine. I'm not entirely sure if this is completely accurate, but they had come from Tennessee to Missouri because they had a private gig to do. Now, they are strippers, but the way it was worded, it made it seem like they were there for more than just dancing, if you know what I mean. But like I said, this is all speculation for me at this point in time. Now, I'm not saying that just because you are a stripper, because it's not a jab against, you know, stripping or sex work or anything. I'm not saying just because you're a stripper that you don't have any discernible skills. There are a lot of very smart and very talented strippers. I mean, just look at the music game nowadays. But these hoes were exceptionally useless because while they were in Missouri, a tire popped. And so they pulled over at like a gas station or a service station. They're like, oh no, what are we going to do? That's when they came across Ralph Cross. He's a 55-year-old local, and everybody in the community had nothing but good things to say about him. Everybody says things like he always buys like school supplies for the children around school time. He was giving money out to people all the time and helping people whenever they needed help. Just like a regular dude. So they introduced themselves to him.
Hey, my name is Pope Nisha. I'm 23 years old, and when I was 14, my foot got ran over by a bike, and ever since then, I can't have my period no more. Hey, I'm Jonisha, I'm 19, and last year I was real constipated and took a laxative, and ever since then, I don't get my period no more. I'm Lautisha, I'm a bad bitch, I'm 23 years old. Fun fact about me is one time my ex-boyfriend, who also my cousin, he punched me in my left titty, it hurt like hell, and ever since then, I can't get my period no more.
My name is Brittany. I'm 28 years old. I'm the baddest bitch. I'm the Beyonce to them hoes. The rest of them just Kelly's and Michelle's. And one time I had an allergic reaction to some spaghetti that I ate at my auntie's house. And I don't get my period no more.
Now back to Ralph. But now he comes across these four bitches with no discernible skills, and they have a flat tire at a gas station. And he asks them what the problem is. They proceed to tell him that even though they have one of the easiest jobs on earth, which is just shaking your ass for cash, they don't have any money. Now, me personally, I wouldn't trust it, because all you gotta do is literally shake your ass and flash your vajayjay. You ain't got no money, that means you ain't good at your job. I would've left them hoes. And then on top of this, they don't have money for a tire. Tires are literally like $120. It's like $30 a girl. I mean, how can you be a hoe and not even be a $40 hoe? But whatever, Ralph has a heart of gold, and so he's like, I'll help you bitches out. So he actually uses his own money, and he buys them a tire. But then four useless bitches, they get the tire, and they're like, okay, does it like screw itself on? And Ralph was like, okay, well, I'll put the tire on for you then.
And not only that, but he also offers to let the women stay with him until he fixes the car. I'm going to pause, because I have a few thoughts and theories about what's happening right now. Okay, so we know that the women came to Missouri because they had a private whatever thing going on. But we also know that they did not have money to buy a $120 tire. So they obviously didn't have money for a hotel. And not to talk down on his character or anything, not like that, but he's a man. This is just what I believe. I believe that he offered to buy the tire. They were whores. They need a place to stay. And he was like, you know, you stay with me, you know, for a couple days. And I'll fix your tire. Because, I mean, you're just changing the tire. It only takes 15 minutes to do so. There's no reason to let someone stay at your house while you fix a tire. Unless. I'm just critically thinking. And we do know that the women stayed at his house for at least 2 days. I mean, do I have to just come out and say it for you people? All right. I believe that he was sleeping with the women. I believe they were strippers. They didn't want to buy a hotel room. They ain't had no money, so they exchanged sex for a place to stay in a tire. That's what I believe. I'm not saying that he's wrong. I'm not going against his character, but we have to use our minds here. And this is just my opinion. So what you gonna do about it? Anyway, back to the story. August the 1st, 2017, he is outside of his house and he is yelling with these bitches. A witness sees him walking towards his own house, and then he walks into the house while one of the girls sits inside of the car, and he's in the house with the three other women. He was surrounded by three broke hoes. He was outnumbered, and so they united. Jonisha!
Jonisha! It's Brittany, bitch.
Now, it's a little unclear exactly what they were arguing about, so no one really knows at this point in
second time. But they were arguing about something, and Brittany got a gun, a 9mm, and shot him in the back. Now, after the woman had shot him, they ransacked the house looking for money. They turned his pockets inside out. They flipped all the couch cushions. They robbed him whatever they could find, and then they ran to their car, and then they dipped. Now, that same witness that saw him, you know, arguing and then walking to the house and heard the gunshot and saw the woman run out, actually heard the women, because as the women were passing by this witness, they sort of slowed down, and one of them said, "He tripping. Do not go back down there. He tripping, but y'all just shot him." They took off in their white Nissan Sentra, and they were gone with the wind. Now, after a couple of days of their faces being all over the news for murder, they were coerced by family members who saw them on the news to turn themselves in which case they all have. Now, even though they've all turned themselves in, no one has admitted their part of the murder. However, some of them have indicated that it was Brittany that shot them. They have been all charged with first-degree murder, but I couldn't really find anything on what they have been sentenced with, if they've been sentenced at this point in time. But yeah, rest in peace, big dog. You didn't deserve it. Once again, this video was not meant to offend anyone who's exotic dancers or anything like that. Like I said, I love strippers. I have been known to throw $12 at the club. Yeah, this story sucks. Crazy, right?
It is a heinous crime sparked, police say, by a husband enraged that his wife might be having an affair. What happened next, we have to warn you, is so violent it may not be appropriate for some viewers.
This woman has two black eyes, the result, cops say, of a beating by her enraged husband after he discovered she was having an affair with a co-worker. What authorities say happened next is shocking.
This case is especially heinous and gruesome.
31-year-old Brittany Barron told police her husband Armando was looking through her phone when he found text messages from her co-worker Jonathan Amaralt. They both worked at a medical supply company in New Hampshire. Brittany said what followed was a violent assault, with her husband beating her about the face repeatedly and strangling her so hard she says she passed out. Then her husband texted her lover pretending to be Brittany and lured him to meet at a park in the woods. When Amaralt showed up for the middle of the night rendezvous with his alleged lover, a grim fate awaited him. That's when Brittany told investigators her husband turned and shot Jonathan three times, twice in the chest and once in the head. The couple then drove 200 miles with the body into the deep forests of New Hampshire, where the husband ordered Brittany to cut off Jonathan's head with a saw so that he could not be identified, according to court documents.
The defendant decapitated Jonathan, wrapped his head in a tarp, and placed it in a grave.
The gruesome crime was exposed when fish and game officers happened to come upon the scene. Armando Barron has pled not guilty to murder. His wife was charged with falsifying physical evidence. She pled not guilty when she appeared in court, and you could still see those two black eyes.
You can hear me, right?
Yes, I can.
For lawyer Richard Guerriero.
Everything that the state alleges that Ms. Barron did, she did under duress, and I mean under duress, meaning direct fear for her life.
That's crazy.
Can I just say one thing before I get started, because there's people calling my phone and threatening me? So I just want to say, and they're calling me homeless and all this stuff. I did an interview with Tasha K, and she labeled me as Carl Thomas homeless baby mom. So I didn't appreciate that, number one, because, okay, when I met Carl Thomas, I met him when I had a show not only on ABC but on the CW doing my own thing, and that's how I met him, interviewing him. So I was not homeless. I owned my salon for 16 years, so that is not correct. Now, when I moved to Atlanta, I did become homeless, and that was recently. I was homeless about 5-6 months ago, and I was open with Tasha about that, and for her to label me and have that as the caption, number one, it wasn't true. I didn't sleep with him as a homeless woman who just went to his room one night because I was homeless. No, I knew this man at least 6 or 7 years before we even slept together, slept with him once and chose not to deal with him anymore. And he was salty and chooses not to take care of his daughter. I'm gonna say one thing, public records are definitely, child support is definitely public records. So anybody, my name is Latoya Young. If you want, you know his name, Carlton and Ron Thomas. If you want to look it up, it's public record. So I have nothing to hide. I have nothing to make up. I'm a woman on here trying to look for a man just like anybody else. And I'm entitled to that. And just because who my baby father is shouldn't affect that and shouldn't have y'all calling me and threatening me. If you want to know the real, it's public record. Tasha K has all the paperwork and has been following this story since I was pregnant.
Papa Thomas ain't got no money like that either after what Diddy did to him.
Yo, TikTok, I got to deviate from the topic at hand. Does anybody know this young lady right here? On Facebook, she goes by K Rhea. I happened to be strolling and I saw somebody shared a post where she had written an unaliving note saying that she was tired. She had been crying out. She had been seeking help. She had been wanting somebody to just see who she is. And here's a little bit of it. But you guys, I need whoever. Y'all got to share this. Y'all got to get this to every platform. We need to find out who this is and if she's okay. The post has been up for about an hour. But reading that long post, baby girl is hurting. She is hurting. She seemed to have lost somebody who was near and dear to her. She posted a couple days ago, and today she's writing an unaliving note. K Rhea, y'all. I've shared her on my page. I'm bringing it to TikTok, but we need to bring awareness and figure out if this baby girl is okay. Please.
Well, hopefully that went viral. I have to follow up and see if K Rhea is still in the land of the living. I know life gets hard, y'all. Believe me, but the sun will shine again if you hold out. Life is so short, you know, stick around and see if it comes up for you. It will. It always does. Y'all stay safe. It's the weekend. I want y'all to go out and enjoy ourselves. I'm going to try to do the same. It's been a long week for me, myself, and I'm still here. Y'all are too. So stay strong. Stay safe. I'll be praying for you guys. Pray for me and my little kins and cairns that live in my neighborhood. I pray travel and mercy over y'all. And I just pray that y'all stay safe. I'll talk to you guys on Monday.